guys, Libby News here. So today I'll be doing the unused executions from Super Dragon Boat Sue. And before I was planning on doing a character analysis video, but I was working a lot this week and honestly it would have gone up a lot later than this video, so I figured I would just do this one first. So hopefully that doesn't bum too many of you guys out. I'll definitely do a character analysis next week. But it seems like a lot of you guys enjoyed the last video, so I figured I might as well go ahead and do this one next since I actually understand all of the trivia relating to it now as well. I did a ton of research and to my knowledge, the Super Dragon Boat Sue visual fanbook doesn't actually contain descriptions of unused executions like the Danganronpa 1 one has. But there is a doshinji by the Pixiv user Orima who created their own summaries and made fan art to go along with it. The fan art in this book is included along with the fan art that they created for the Danganronpa 1 unused executions, which did have official descriptions with them. The artwork for this and the descriptions are not actually on their Pixiv account, but they do have a post that advertises for the doujin, and they also have a link to where you could once buy it as well. Unfortunately, it looks as if you can't actually purchase it, at least on that link that they provided, but you can actually go on there and request that the artist resells it. So I'll link that down below if anybody's curious as to what that is. A lot of people, including myself, thought that these were actually official descriptions of the executions because someone a while back translated this page that was actually from the doujinji, but a lot of people mistook it as it being from the official fanbook, which led to people posting these descriptions and the art all over the internet without sources, causing a lot of confusion and people believing that these were official. So I just wanted to get that out of the way to clear up any confusion. Although I will say that a lot of the information I've gained regarding this has been from me Google translating Japanese pages or based off of information I've seen other people who actually own the official fanbook saying that the descriptions weren't actually in them. So I don't own the fanbook myself. It's not in English to my knowledge. And feel free to correct me if I'm wrong on any of this information, but I spent a long time looking this up and I'm like 99% sure this is how it is. But moving on, I also want to mention that Matsuda and Nagi's unused executions will also be included in this. I planned on actually including Nagi's unused execution in the last video, but once I realized that the description for it was fan-made, I decided it would probably fit a bit better in this one, so I decided to take that one out last minute. Also, before I start the video, I do want to mention that several characters in this list actually had canon executions in the game, and other characters that either survived or were victims, like Akane, Ibuki, Sayonji, and Nidai, don't actually have unused executions that were included in this work. But anyways, with all of that out of the way, let's go ahead and get on with the video. So number 10 on this list is Sonya Nevermind's execution, and it is called Princess Sonya. Sonya is made into a Snow White puppet by Monokuma. As the plot continues, Sonya ate the apple but did not wake up again. The story ends with a happy ending where Monokuma, as Snow White's stepmother, lived happily ever after. I do like this execution. I love the princess theme and can definitely imagine Monokuma being a little shit and dressing up as a stepmom and giving the villain the happy ending. Kind of similar to what he did with the Wizard of Monami in Chapter 3. So the whole idea of that is super funny to me, and I think it's a cool execution based off of her talent. Although I will say I do think it would have been really cool if her unused execution would have had more to do with her interest in Freemasonry or with the occult. Specifically Freemasonry, because then her execution could have been a mixture of her interest in the occult and her talent being a government figurehead as well, since there are so many conspiracy theories linked to Freemasonry. Next up is Chiaki's unused execution, which is OX Life or Death Game. Trapped on a Sugo Roku board, Nanami was made to move the steps determined by the dices. She managed to avoid a dangerous tile, but Monokuma changed all the tiles into death tiles. Without any choice, Nanami stepped on an electric tile and was electrocuted from the feet up. So if you guys were like me and you weren't familiar with this game, it's basically similar to Snakes and Ladders, and it's when you roll the dice and move a number of spaces based off of the number of the dice. It's a really simple game. It's played by adults and children, and I also saw online that in Japan it's actually traditionally played on New Year's Day, which strangely enough is the same day as Hajime's birthday. So I don't have too much to say about this. I do like this execution. The only reason that it's kind of ranked low is because I just loved her actual execution so much. Seeing her and Monami basically fight for their lives, that whole execution was really dramatic and cool to me. But as for this execution, I do think there could be some symbolism with Sugoroku being related to January 1st. I was thinking it could symbolize a new beginning, since after this trial, you do enter the 6th chapter where you learn the rest of the secrets regarding the second killing game, and when you begin to really see the overall theme of the second game, which is creating your own future. Next up on the list is Matsuda's execution, and like I said before, although he is a character from Danganronpa Zero, I decided to still include him on this list since it is included in the fanbook. Also, there might be slight spoilers for Danganronpa Zero, so just go ahead and skip to the time I'm showing on the screen if you want to miss those. But his execution is called Black White. A tied up Matsuda is transported into a dark hospital. He ends up in the operating room and a group of Monokuma doctors surround him. The red light of the operating room lights up. From the outside, silhouettes of something drill-like can be seen. Almost immediately, the operating room explodes. The explosion is big enough to destroy the entire hospital. Inside the wreckage, a few pieces of paper were found. On them are hand-drawn pictures that look like a Monokuma doctor, with a warning that he is a fake doctor. Matsuda died in the explosion. I like how this whole execution resembles his talent as the ultimate neurologist. And once again, I always think it's super funny to see these little bits with Monokuma just being a little shit and showing a picture of him as a fake doctor. My only complaint with it is that it does feel like it kind of ends abruptly, and with executions like this, in my opinion, it kind of takes out some of the suspense and drama around it. I also would have really liked to have seen Junko somewhere in the execution, or just something implying their relationship together as well, since she would be the one to actually make his execution. Next up is Mihiru's execution, and it is called Real Photo. Mihiru is left in deserted ruins. Beside her is a photo album with her name on it. The picture inside shows herself in the same deserted ruins looking into the same photo album. As she flips through the pages, a white hand starts to clamp around her neck, and the final picture shows her lying on the floor. While she is in shock, a camera starts to begin to shoot. When she tries to throw away the camera, a white hand appears behind her without her noticing. This is definitely a very creepy and mysterious execution in my opinion, and it's a really cool idea going off the idea of her talent as well. I love the idea of her seeing her death in photos right before it happens. I can just picture the whole execution in my mind and imagine how disturbing it would be not only for me as a player, but also for the remaining students as well. Next up is Kazuya Koichi's execution, and it is called Underground Travels. Soda is forced into a drilling machine. The door closes and the machine starts to drill into the ground below. It continues on drilling until it reaches the mantle of the earth, and Soda melts along with the machine. Similarly to Mihiru's, I don't really have too much to say about this execution. I saw some people online saying that it kind of feels like a reverse Jin Kirigiri's, and I have to agree with that. I feel like it's a simple idea, but it's very haunting, and I feel like it's something that would leave a really big impact on me if it were included in the game. Also, the same artist did create an alternate execution, which is included on their Pixiv account, so I will link that one down below if any of you would like to look at it. Number 5 on the list is Gundam's execution called Running Tanaka. Gundam is in a giant hamster's wheel chased by a giant Monokuma ball. He finally trips and the 4 Dark Devas of Destruction fall out. He rushes to protect them from being crushed by the Monokuma ball, but he dies with a satisfied smile. Anything that has to do with Gundam's hamsters dying or almost dying just absolutely kills me. And I really love this execution because it really tugs at your heartstrings, and I really like the canon execution as well. I thought it was sad enough just having to watch his hamster see him in his dying moments, but him actually going out of his way to save their lives and then die in front of them is just way, way sadder to me. So I actually think that I might like this execution a little bit better than his real one, just because him going out of his way to save the hamsters raises the stakes a little bit more and also pulls at your heartstrings just a bit more as well, at least in my opinion. Next up on the list is Fuhiko's execution, and it is called Best Battle. Kazuryu is hiding in the midst of a gang battle. A Yakuza-style Monokuma is involved in the fight as well. Monokuma spotted a shadow which resembles Pekko and made his way towards her. Seeing the this, Kuzuryu rushed forward to cover her, but was shot fatally. Pekko seems to notice this and turned around to face him. It turns out to be another Monokuma. Kuzuryu dies with a regretful smile. Similarly to Pekko's actual execution in the game, I find this one absolutely heartbreaking and super good. I'm not really much into shipping, but I've always loved their relationship and how much we see that they care for each other. And at first when I heard of this execution, it seemed almost like his version of the Pekko execution, and I imagined it taking place in the second trial. But on second thought, I think it would be even sadder if this was an execution that took place towards the end of the game after we have already seen her death, because then we would see his reaction to thinking he sees like her ghost or something along those lines. Because for that half second, we would see him have that sort of hope that she still is alive, and that his gut reaction, even knowing rationally there's no way she's alive, it would still be to protect her. Next on the list is Hajime's execution, and it is called Scratch D Hinata. Hajime is printed on a scrap paper. Monokuma picks up a coin and starts to scrape the paper, while Hajime remains helpless. After Hajime is completely scraped off, the word try again is revealed. Disappointed, Monokuma throws away the paper. Hajime's existence is disappearing once again and dies. I know I always talk a lot about how I want the executions to be more realistic, and even though I know this one isn't even like remotely realistic at all, I just love it, honestly. It's super weird and fucked up, but I think it's really cool. I love how they based it off of the idea of his identity disappearing again, like it did with the Izuru Kamakura project, and I'm guessing that's what the try again symbolizes as well. Also, Orama did create an alternate execution for Hajime, which I'll link down below, and they created one for Izuru as well, if you guys would like to check that one out too. Next up is Naigi's execution, and as mentioned before, this was actually on my list for the Danganronpa 1 unused executions, but since I found out these were all fan-made, I decided to put it on this one instead. But this execution is called 100 Swords. Naigi is put into a large barrel and Monokuma closes the lid. When he's about to escape, a sword comes in from the exterior and grazes his face. While Naigi is shocked with fear, more and more swords are thrusted into the barrel. The barrel is wobbling in the beginning, but after a number of swords, it stops moving. Monokuma peeks into the barrel and closes it hastily. He runs away and the screen blacks out. I've always really loved this execution because to me it highlights Naigi's good luck talent in a really simple but cool way by showing him just barely missing death with that first sword before it finally catches up with him. And even though I know this is fan made, I do like to think that this could have been the execution that happened in the first game if the remaining survivors would have chosen to execute Naigi in the sixth trial. And the number one unused execution on this list is Kamaida's execution, and it is called Rope Master. Kamaida is standing on a platform that resembles a circus's flying trapeze. Countless ropes are hung onto the platform. Monokuma begins to cut off the ropes one by one, but all of them are not connected to anything. Frustrated, he punches the cutting board and sets the platform on fire. Monokuma escapes. Kamaida, with no ropes or any other way to escape, dies. I honestly had a really hard time choosing the number one for this list, unlike the last one where I knew from the very beginning that Ishimaru's would be number one, and I really didn't want to choose Kamaida's as a number one on this list because he is my favorite character and I didn't want it to come across as being too biased or I'm just choosing it because I like his character. I really do think overall, even taking my love for the character out of it, this is my favorite execution out of these because of how cool I think the imagery is and how the execution sort of relates to his talent as well. It seems like the execution might resemble his luck cycle, which we learn about in his free time events. So the initial bad luck being the fact that he's in an execution, and the good luck being next that once Monokuma begins cutting the ropes, nothing falls. And then of course the bad luck once again being that the platform catches on fire and kills him that way. I also think the imagery is really cool in this art because you can actually see him smiling and drooling a little bit, which reminds me of how interesting it would have been to see Kamaida get executed in the games since you probably would have been actually excited about being a stepping stool for the rest of the students. I feel like a death by fire is one of the most brutal and probably mortifying ways to watch somebody die too, so I think he would have been excited to die this way since he would probably think that this is an even greater stepping stool since the rest of the Ultimates would watch him die in such a despair-inducing way. Orima actually created an alternate execution for Kamida as well, which is on their Pixiv account, and I'll link that down below if you guys want to look at that one too. But anyways, that will conclude the video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I do think that out of all the unused executions, including these fan-made ones, Ishimaru's is still my favorite. And feel free to let me know what your favorite is out of all of these as well. And thanks guys so much for supporting the last video. It did much better than I ever thought it would, so I really appreciate that. A few of you guys left really good comments about Sakura and Tagami's execution and how those could be interpreted, the parts that I wasn't interpreting very well, so I thought those were really cool too. I'll put those up on the screen. And as for my next video, like I said, I do want to do another character analysis video. I'll probably go through and actually just count comments and decide who I do an analysis based off of those. After this one though, I really do want to do a Kirigiri character analysis just personally, so I'll probably do that one, not this next one, but the one after that. And I'm planning on making another V3 theory video too pretty soon as well, since I know a couple of you guys were asking about those. But anyways, thanks again guys for supporting these videos and leaving likes and comments. I really appreciate it, and I just wanted to take some time to actually say that. And I'll try to keep you guys updated on who I decide to do a character analysis video on next after I go through and count all the comments. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I will see you real soon.
Subscribe to Weeby News for more hope-filled videos.